Surveying today relies heavily on the Global Positioning System, GPS, or similar systems from other countries, collectively known as Global Navigation Satellite Systems. Today's satellite-based technology can help people determine accurate positions and elevations more efficiently than in the past. The benefits of using GPS to determine accurate positions and elevations will be even greater when NGS defines new datums. Let's take a look at the planned new datums and some of their expected benefits. Horizontal positions are currently defined by the North American Datum of 1983, or NAD83. This will be replaced by a new geometric datum, which provides latitude, longitude, height, and time information. Vertical positions or elevations are currently defined by the North American Vertical Datum of 1988, or NAVD88. This will be replaced with a new vertical or geopotential datum. The new datums will help lessen the impact of aging physical infrastructure, like marks, that currently help define NAD83 and NAVD88. The new geometric datum that will replace NAD83 will rely completely on reference stations that continuously receive GPS information. NGS maintains the Coors Network, which stands for Continuously Operating Reference Stations. Users can reference Coors to help accurately determine any geometric position, which includes latitude, longitude, and some elevation information. Coors provides elevation information computed using an ellipsoid model of the Earth. An ellipsoid can be used as a rough approximation of the shape of the Earth. However, we know that the Earth is not shaped like a perfect ellipsoid. As a result, we need another model, one that reflects the varied topography of the Earth, including features such as mountains and valleys. This new model, called a geoid, is based on the variations in gravity across the Earth's surface. The geoid model is the basis for the new vertical or geopotential datum. This new datum will combine the ellipsoid height and the geoid height at the same point to calculate its elevation. To help improve accuracy of the new vertical datum, NGS is completing a major project called Gravity for the Redefinition of the American Vertical Datum, or GRAVD. NGS is flying over the entire U.S. and collecting a unique, continuous gravity dataset that will help us build a better geoid model, which will improve the accuracy of elevations measured using GPS technology. When the new datums are adopted, positioning information for existing structures and marks will change. The scale of the change will vary depending on your location, ranging from 0.5 to 1.5 meters in a horizontal direction and 0 to 1.3 meters in elevation. These changes, based on our newest positioning technology and scientific knowledge, will provide more accurate positioning information. They will have impacts in areas ranging from transportation, construction, floodplain mapping, agriculture, and more. Even though the change is years away, the time to prepare is now. While tools will be available to facilitate the transformation of specific position information, it can take years to change products, services, or databases. You may want to begin examining current databases and records that may be impacted and plan for the effort required to update. In addition, many state and other governmental entities passed laws requiring that public works or maps reference NAD83 or NAVD88. Those laws or contracts will need to be changed to reflect the new datum. Starting to plan now will help you be well positioned for the change. Resources are available and continue to be developed by NOAA's National Geodetic Survey.